Hello friends, welcome again. I am Dhruvo. We started discussing about new Java advanced features since previous video of this series. If you missed that one, I encourage you to watch it to have some context. In this video, we will do hands-on coding about functional interface, which was introduced in Java 8 to support use of lambda expression, method reference, etc. Now here we will discuss about functional interface. Functional interface provide target types of lambda expression and method interfaces. Each functional interface has a single abstract method called functional method for that interface. Now there are two types of functional interface. One is built-in functional interface provided by the JDK itself, like for example predicate interface, which has single boolean test method. And there is another type of you can custom build your own functional interface. Now let's move to an IDE so we can demonstrate how we can create functional interface. I'm using STS Spring Tool Suite IDE, and also black theme is enabled. It is better for our eyes. By default, it gives you a light theme, which is basically based on white background. So let's quickly create a Java project. Let's name it demo functional interface. And you can choose Java 8 version onwards. You may choose 9, 10, and even 11 as well. So let's click on finish. It will give you a project in left panel. Now let's create an interface. Now I'm using package com.examples. And name, let's say drivable. It automatically creates drivable interface. Now here you can define your single abstract method. Let's create a method void drive. Let's save it. And also you can mark it using @func, and if you press control space, ID will automatically fill it up, functional interface. So that means everybody knows that this interface is type of functional interface. Now to use this interface, let's create another class under the same package. Let's name it car. And also I'm using public static void main so I can execute some code. Now here, let's remove this to do. Now let's define an object, drivable. Let's car. And now I'm using lambda expression, which I will demonstrate in our next video elaborately. Now let's implement the drive method using simple sysout. I am driving a car. And if you want to use this implementation, we just need to call car.drive. That's it. Now let's run this program. Here we can see this printout. I am driving a car, right? So clearly we have not written any explicit class or anonymous class to implement that drivable interface. So this is the first type of functional interface that we have implemented. Now let's assume we want to pass some parameter here, right? So let's create a duplicate interface of drivable, copy it and paste it in IDE. Let's change the name. Let's say drivable with param. So if you open the drivable with param, here we can change the signature of the method. Let's say we want to pass a string and name of the car or car type. Now go back to the car class. And here, if you want to define another object, drivable, which is type of drivable with parameter now, and create a variable car2. Here again, I'm using lambda expression. Now this time we want to pass a variable here, which should match with the signature of the drive method, car type. You do not need to put a variable type here, but definitely it should exactly match the signature of the drive method. Now again, we are using CISO to implement this method. And I am writing, I am driving a car, or rather I am driving then plus, and using the variable to get the car type. Now if you want to call this car2.drive, and car type we are passing Audi. Now if we run this program, we'll see I am driving a car for first one, and second one I am driving Audi. So I believe after these examples, you understand how functional interface can be implemented. One thing you have to remember, one functional interface must only contain single abstract method. It cannot have multiple abstract methods. Like for example, if you want to define another method here, let's say for example, void stop, your IDE will automatically gives you an error stating invalid functional interface. So you cannot use more than one abstract method. However, you can implement multiple default methods inside a functional interface. In this way, you can write another default method here. Now let's go back to the car class. Next, let me show you few additional built-in functional interface that have been provided by JDK itself. So if you open java.util.function, now if we press control space, we will see many built-in functional interfaces. So starting with predicate, we'll demonstrate implementing predicate interface in our next video. And if you like this video, please subscribe this channel and don't forget to hit the bell icon.